we are going to solve few problems related to the quadratic expressions, or you may say it as equations. See the first problem and the second problem. First of all, I am going to solve the second one. The problem says it. This is an equation x minus a into x minus b minus k is equals to 0 is a quadratic equation, and whose roots are c, d. The roots of this equation are c and d. And now they are asking us to find the roots for this particular equation. Have a look at this. See, one equation is given whose roots are c and d. Another equation is given, and we need to find the roots of the second equation. So to find the roots of the second equation, we need to get the help or support of the first equation. Yeah. And actually, it's an objective question. If you look at the options, the roots of this equation are in terms of ABs. Okay. That means you need to find the roots of the second equation in terms of A comma B. Here A and B are involved. So you need to utilize the relations on A and B in the second equation to get the roots. And now look here. What I have to do? The first equation is this: x minus a, x minus b minus k is equals to 0, whose roots are c and d. First of all, you just multiply this x minus a into x minus b with the usual multiplication: x square minus a plus b times of x plus ab minus k is equals to 0. Is there anything wrong? See, usual multiplication: x into x is x square, x into b is minus bx. A into x is minus ax, minus a into minus b is plus ab, minus k is equals to 0. And for this equation, as they mentioned, the roots are c and d. Since the roots are c and d for this equation, you just write the sum of the roots as well as the product of the roots. Sum of the roots, c plus d is equals to minus x coefficient by x square coefficient. You need to recall that. Sum of the roots of a quadratic equation is minus x coefficient divided by the x square coefficient. Here x coefficient is minus of a plus b, and we need to write minus of this x coefficient. So a plus b by 1, so c plus d is 1. And c into d, the product of roots is the constant term divided by the x square coefficient. If you look at the equation, this ab minus k is completely the constant involved in this equation. This is x square term, this is x term, and this is the constant. And that CD here, it is AB minus K. Have a look at this. C plus D, I have it as A plus B. CD as AB minus K, just from the sum and product of the roots. Now, this is the just analyzation of the given equation. And now you just think about the second equation. You need to find the roots for that. So to find the roots, again just simplify it. On simplification, you get it as X square minus of C plus D times of X plus CD plus K is equals to 0. Is there anything wrong? Nothing there. See, the usual multiplication: x into x is x square, CX, DX, and then CD minus K. And now, since I need to find the roots in terms of A and B, so you just replace C and D with that relations of AB. Here C plus D is A plus B, and CD is equals to AB minus K. Look at this. CD is equals to AB minus K. Then what you say about CD plus K? For sure it is AB. So X square minus this C plus D is nothing but A plus B times of X plus CD plus K is just nothing but AB is equals to 0. Actually, there is no A and B in the first second equation. And the first equation, it involves with AB. The roots are C and D. With the support of this first equation, I get the terms AB in the second. And now it is x square minus of a plus b times of x plus ab is equals to 0. And you know that its factorization is x minus a into x minus b is equals to 0. Since the product is 0, either the first one is 0 or the second one is 0, from there it is clear that x is equals to a or b, and at the end, the roots for this second equation are a comma b. Have a look at this. For the first equation, the roots are c comma d. And then for the second equation, the roots are a comma b. And this is first problem of today's class. Have a look, go with the screenshot, and then I will give you the explanation for the another one. Okay, have a look at it. Look at the problem on the board. The equation x square plus ax minus b is equals to 0 has two roots, alpha and beta. And the equation x square plus ax plus b is equals to 0 has two roots, gamma and delta. And they ask us to find the value of this product. See, alpha, beta, gamma, delta. All they are Greek letters, and usually we use those letters to represent the roots of the quadratic equations. See, for the first equation, alpha, beta are the roots. So I have different conditions with my hands. Yeah, first observation what I have is, see, alpha plus alpha and beta are the roots for the first equation. Then sum of the roots, alpha plus beta is equals to, as I told you, minus x coefficient by x square coefficient. Here x coefficient is a, minus x coefficient means minus a, by x square coefficient is 1, that is equals to minus a. And what you say about alpha into beta? Alpha into beta is the constant term by x square coefficient, and you get it as minus b, right? From the first equation, since alpha beta are the roots, we have these two. And now look at the second equation. And for the second equation, I mentioned you that the roots are gamma and delta. And now, what you say about gamma and delta? See, gamma plus delta is again the sum of the roots, minus x coefficient by x square coefficient, which is 1. So again it is 1. And gamma into delta is equals to what? The product of the roots. And it is directly b, constant term. See, I have alpha plus beta, alpha into beta. And gamma plus delta and gamma delta. I need to utilize these things to find that value. And also if I need, I will use the basic definition of the root. What is the basic definition of the root? See, if alpha is a root, it must satisfy this equation. Since beta is a root, it must satisfy this equation. Gamma is root for this, it satisfies this as well as delta also. If it needs, I will use that, okay? And now, just look at this. We need to multiply all these things. But as a part of multiplication, I will just collect the first one and third one like this. Alpha minus gamma into alpha minus delta into beta minus delta into beta minus gamma. Actually, I have four terms here. See, for my convenience, I am just taking the first one and third one as well as second one and fourth one like this. And now, while multiplication, first multiply these two and then multiply these two. If you multiply the first two terms, alpha into alpha is just what? Alpha square. Yeah. And then, alpha into delta, gamma into alpha. Alpha is a common thing, and I can write it like this. Gamma plus delta times of alpha plus gamma into delta. The product of the first two terms. And now, if you look at the second two terms, beta square, beta into beta, and then beta into gamma, beta into delta. Again, beta is a common thing. So, gamma plus delta times of beta plus gamma delta. And this is the product of the next thing. Now, clearly there is alpha plus delta and gamma plus delta and gamma into delta involved in these two. So, use that gamma plus delta as minus a, gamma into delta as b. So, now if you utilize these two things, you have that. The first bracket is alpha square, gamma plus delta is minus a. If you replace this gamma plus delta with minus a, minus of minus plus a alpha plus gamma into delta is b. This is the first bracket. And now look at the second bracket. Since beta square, again gamma plus delta is minus a, minus of minus plus a beta plus gamma delta is b. So this is what we have at the end. So this is alpha square plus a alpha plus b, and this is beta square plus a beta plus b. So I have different options. One thing is you need to multiply these two. It becomes somewhat lengthy. So there I will use the basic definition of the root. See, actually there is no use for this with the selection of this group. Okay, so leave it for a while. And now alpha is a root for this first equation. See, I am mentioning here. Since alpha is a root for the first equation, alpha must satisfy it. So, you need to replace x with alpha. You will get that alpha square plus a alpha minus b is equals to 0. just by replacing x with alpha in the first equation. From there, alpha square plus a alpha is equals to b. Just make a note. Alpha square plus a alpha is equals to b. Similarly, beta is also a root for this, and you will get that beta square plus a beta is equals to b. And now you just replace this alpha square plus a alpha with b, as well as this beta square plus a beta with b. And now on replacement, you will get this as b plus b into b plus b. 2b and 2b, the product is 4b square, and your answer for the problem is 4b square. Have a look at this. We are using the multiplication as well as the sum and product of the roots, the basic definition of the root, along with our algebraic skill. Have a look at this and go for a screenshot. See, pay attention on the problem. Have a look here. There is an equation, the general quadratic equation, ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. And for this equation, m plus 1 by m and m plus 2 by m plus 1 are the roots. And now, our task is to find the value of a plus b plus c whole square. The result, the a plus b plus c whole square value is again in terms of abc itself. And we need to find that value. See, actually have a look at this. The problem is somewhat logical with the usual procedure, okay, with the usual manner, by taking sum of the roots, product of the roots, okay, depending on the value of m, it is a bit lengthy or difficult to solve the question actually. So, we need to go with a different approach to solve this question, and that was very wonderful one. You need to, yeah, mark it as a logical question and then different one, okay. And then, this, the question is that ax square plus bx plus c is equals 0 are the roots like m plus 1 by m and m plus 2 by m plus 1. Now, what I am going to do is, since I need to find this a plus b plus c whole square value. Yeah. First of all, I write this root as some alpha, this root as some beta, just for my convenience. Actually, every equation has two roots. And here in particular, they said the roots as m plus 1 by m and m plus 2 by m plus n. And for my convenience, I am taking these two as alpha and beta. Right. So here alpha is nothing but m plus 1 by m and beta is nothing but m plus 2 by m plus n. See, we need to find this a plus b plus c whole square. We know that since these two alpha and beta are roots for this ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0, clearly alpha plus beta is minus b by a and alpha into beta is c by a. Is it right? That's why to use those, you just common out a square from here. See, a square of a plus b by a plus c by a whole square. Is there anything wrong here? See, it's not a, it's just 1. Right. Look at this. A square of 1 plus b by a plus c by a whole square. Or otherwise, you may write it like this. A plus b plus c whole square, right? So, a times of 1 plus b by a plus c by a whole square. Is it right now? Square is just like it. You just rearrange this a plus b plus c as a times of 1 plus b by a plus c by a, right? And now here, alpha and beta are the roots for that. We know that alpha plus beta is how much? Minus b by a. And alpha into beta is what? C by a. So you just replace this b by a with minus alpha minus beta, because alpha plus beta is minus b by a. And replace this c by a with alpha beta. So this is equals to a square is a square. 1, b by a is nothing but minus alpha minus beta plus c by a is nothing but alpha beta whole square. Is it right? So, a square of 1 minus alpha minus beta plus alpha beta whole square. And now this is equals to a square of 1 minus alpha minus alpha beta is just nothing but 1 minus alpha into 1 minus beta whole square. Have a look at this. See, a square of 1 minus alpha, 1 minus beta. The product 1 minus alpha into 1 minus beta is just nothing but this. 1 minus alpha minus beta plus alpha beta whole square only. So, a square of 1 minus alpha into 1 minus beta whole square. And now actually, what is alpha and what is beta? You just replace them. And this is equals to yeah, a square of 1 minus alpha. 1 minus of alpha is just nothing but m plus 1 by m, and beta is just nothing but 1 minus of m plus 2 by m plus 1, and we have a square for it, right? And now this is equals to a square of this 1 minus m plus 1 by m is just nothing but, if you simplify, yeah, minus 1 by m. Is it right? M minus m minus 1 minus 1 by m. And here if you simplify, m plus 1 minus m plus 2. M and m will get cancelled. Again, that is minus 1 by m plus 1 whole square. And then what I have? Minus into minus is plus. So a square into 1 by m into m plus 1 whole square I have with my hands. So have a note this. You mark it and then further we need to simplify. First of all, to find this a plus b plus c whole square value, by rearranging this a plus b plus c whole square as a times of 1 plus b by a plus c by a whole square, and replacing b by a with alpha plus beta, that means minus alpha minus beta, and c by a with alpha beta, I have this a square times of 1 minus alpha into 1 minus beta whole square, and that is equals to a square times 1 minus alpha is 1 minus of this first root, 1 minus beta is 1 minus of this second root, and on simplification you have that a square into 1 by m into m plus 1 whole square is just what? A plus b plus c whole square. And now see, to get this a plus b plus c whole square value in terms of a, b, c, we need to eliminate this m terms right here. And now you need to rewrite this m terms in terms of again a, b, c. That's what we need to think. For that, my idea is, I will erase this for the space concern and I will do. Have a look at this. At the end, what we have in our hands? At the end, we have that a plus b plus c whole square is a square times 1 by m into m plus 1 whole square. I think everybody noted it, okay? And now, see, alpha, beta have, see, on the other hand, other side, see, alpha is equals to m plus 1 by m is nothing but what? I may write it like this, 1 plus 1 by m, is there anything wrong? Just by pure observation that m plus 1 by m, you just split it, m by m plus 1 by m is this 1 plus 1 by m, and from here, what is beta? You just write it like m plus 2 as m plus 1 plus 1, is it right? See, if you write it like this, it is nothing but 1 by 1 plus m plus 1, if you need, just go with LCM. And now this is alpha and this is beta. One is a common thing. If you subtract, if you remove that one, that in the sense alpha minus beta is equals to 1 by m minus 1 by m plus 1. And since alpha minus beta is 1 by m minus 1 by m plus n, if you took LCM, it becomes like m plus 1 minus m, and directly you will get that 1 by m times m plus 1. Is it clear? And now we need a plus b plus c whole square. Here 1 by m into m plus 1 is involved, and here also I get that 1 by m into m plus 1 as alpha minus beta, and in the next step I will write it like this, a square times of alpha minus beta whole square. See, what you say about this alpha minus beta whole square? A square times of difference of roots. Yeah. Maybe in this first or second class, I mentioned to you about the sum of roots as well as the difference of roots. That difference of the roots is just nothing but a square times difference of the roots is nothing but root of b square minus 4ac by a whole square. Difference of the roots is this one, root delta by a, root of b square minus 4ac by a. And now this a square and a square will get cancelled. Your answer at the end is b square minus 4ac. And a plus b plus c whole square value is what? B square minus 4ac in terms of a, b, c. Right? Think a while. Have a look once again. See, we need to find a plus b plus c whole square, or we need to show a plus b plus c whole square as b square minus 4ac. Further, the general quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equals 0 is given with the roots m plus 1 by m and m plus 2 by m plus 1. Just I write them as alpha and beta. In one side, see, they ask us to find a plus b plus c whole square. If you rearrange it, you will get that value as a square times of 1 by m into m plus 1 whole square. On the other hand, see, this, if you look at this, directly we observe it as 1 plus 1 by m, and with my logic I observe it as 1 plus 1 by m plus 1. Do subtract, and this is 1 by m into m plus 1. See, in both the relations 1 by m into m plus 1 is involved. So since we need to find it, replace that 1 by m into m plus 1 as alpha minus beta here. Square is there, so alpha minus beta square. Difference of the roots square. And difference of the roots, the direct formula is this square. A square and a square will get cancelled. You left with a diagonal b square minus 4ac. So make a note and make a mark it. This is a different problem. So this ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 or has two roots as this, and then a plus b plus c whole square is equal to b square minus 4ac. Just have a look at this, right? So in solving the problems, it may be in any chapter, not only in quadratic. What I am going to tell you is, in solving the problems, after finding solutions for each and every problem, after listening, after finding, after revising the problems, you need to mark those problems in your own way. You need to mark them as like easy, difficult, hard, logical, like this. Or otherwise, you just mark in your own way. Okay? Like, what we say? Star 1, star 2, like that. See, you first star, second star, you give some star rating. See, if you give different ratings for each and every problem according to your attitude, that in the sense, some problems some people may feel as logical, and some other will feel those as difficult, and some other feel those problems as easy. So the marking is dependent on each individual. So you just mark those problems like that. Every time and everywhere you need to go with that procedure. If you mark like that, at the time of examination or at the time of revision, your time will, see, much of your time will get saved with those markings. Because according to the time, you will revise the questions, right? If you have plenty of time, you will revise all the difficult questions, easy questions, logical questions and everything, right? And you need to mark the questions in such a manner that whether they are interesting or not also, right? See, have a look at this now.